is a garden tour for June 7. Everything's growing well. The cilantro is blooming as usual. Some of the bean seeds have sprouted and are growing. Not everything was successful, but these are doing well. The peas have survived a storm on this side of the garden. They're producing lots of pods, at least over here, and also growing along the trellises I had set up and finding additional support in the pole for these hanging baskets. I am growing some okra from seed, and I had planted these on the 2nd of June, so about 5 days ago. And it's amazing because I can already see something sprouting through the soil. That's pretty cool that the seed has germinated within 5 days. And if it's happening in one pot, it's very likely happening in the other pots also. So I'm looking forward to seeing them pop up through the soil more. I harvested some pea pods this morning. I'll probably use them to make pulao or aloo matar sabzi again today. The pups are enjoying the garden. Chiki likes the sun, so she's sitting in the sun partially. Whereas Pari likes the shade with all the fur coat that she has. So she's sitting in a cooler spot of the garden. Everything is growing really well. The volunteer tomato just keeps getting taller, though. I don't know how long it'll last. How much longer it'll last in this terracotta pot. Because it's not enough space for the tomato to really thrive. But we'll see. The beans are taking off, literally. They have been creeping up this wooden stick that I had placed here as additional support, and they'll pretty soon reach the metal trellis and then grow up. The bean on the other side of the garden is already doing that. It's really growing fast. It's grown all the way up to the metal trellis and beyond. I had just a little bit of an artistic touch, but also functional. I created this additional trellis using jute string. It was fairly easy. I just had to weave them in and out and secure them to the top of the metal post here. It looks pretty, and like I said, it's functional because it's going to provide that additional height for the bean plants to climb onto. The Puna Kira is doing well. I trimmed off a few of the lower leaves that seem to be infected with some white spots. And as long as I keep them trimmed, the plant will be fine. The mammoth basil is taking off, and for some reason, half of the leaves have this spiny look. Reminds me a little bit of dragon kale, and the other half is a smooth. It's the same seed, so it's interesting what's going on there. The marigold plants are also beginning to grow, and I had put some additional Puna Kira seeds here just to see if they would sprout as backup, and this one sprouted. It's looking pretty happy too. Not everything has sprouted from seed. These basil seeds don't seem to have germinated. That could be because of the older seed, but I'm gonna keep an eye on this for a couple of more days. If nothing grows, I'll put something else in there. Right, I have my mint is growing in the grow bags. And these tomato, volunteer tomato plants are also doing well. The melons are now beginning to creep up the fence, which I'm using as a trellis. I'm happy. The summer veggies are definitely getting to the point where they require less and less care. All I need to do is to make sure that the soil stays mulched. And if something doesn't grow through the soil, then I just put down new seeds, because there is a significant amount of slug damage on some of these, not all but some. I have some lettuce that has popped up and seems to like the shade over here. The carrot is definitely getting taller. It's climbing up the vine as well. The vine is climbing up the trellis as well. So everything is doing good. There was a certain amount of havoc caused by the storm in this patch as well. Some of the flowering plants were so tall that they got pushed over by the storm. And some of them, including this arugula, so top heavy now that it's dropped to the ground. Again, this is natural part of the process. I'm just again letting them be. The tomatoes are looking happier now that they have a bit more room to grow and breathe. And I can even see some blossoms on one of the tomato plants. Let's see if I can get it in the camera. There you go. So that's cool. The pollinators have been frequenting this space. There's one right there, which is again very cool. So yeah, this whole space is looking happy. I might trim out some of the flowering plants if they do not show signs of reviving. And I'll give more room for the other plants to thrive. It's such a beautiful morning. The birds chirping. Peaceful and quiet. Everything is looking happy. This is the part of the garden that saw the most amount of damage from the storm. These pea plants had been growing really tall, about 7 feet high, and then they got pushed over by the storm and snapped in half. Some of it survived, for instance, this one that's growing along the support provided by the hanging basket post. So that's gonna keep producing a few more pea pods. In the background, the fennel has just gotten taller and taller, and I saw some black swallowtail butterfly caterpillars on it in the morning, early in the morning when I first came down here. And I don't know if I can spot them now, but they don't seem to be doing too much damage, so I'm gonna let them be, let them grow into big beautiful butterflies. Because this fennel's looking pretty happy without them. Some of the bean seeds that I put in have also sprouted. The other side of the fence, these sunflowers have sprouted. I have some butterfly visiting the garden. They look pretty happy, the butterflies. The sunflowers that had been volunteers here have really started exploding. I think it's the combination of the rain and the heat, because these have grown really tall and big. That's really big. It's hiding my entire hand in there.